someone said, hey, Officer Madison, I remember what you told me, and I didn't do what you told me, and look where it got me. So please, please don't waste your life on drugs and alcohol, kids, because there's no way to end up. I mean, you've got a bright future ahead of you, and I want you to do the best you can do. I want you to be the most successful that you can. Does anybody want to raise your hand? Do you remember every time I teach there, at the end of the class, I always tell you one thing before we leave. Does anybody remember what I tell you? It's just one little sentence. What you got? Mr. Banks. You're going to be the police officer. No, you hope you raise your hand. What did I tell y'all? Make safe and what?
Nobody.
Responsible choices, that's right. Every Thursday at the end of class, I say, hey, the weekend's coming, make safe and responsible choices. Okay. Now, to give y'all a little background on when the NARA program started, and we'll move forward. In 1983, Chief Darrell Gates, he was the chief of the Los Angeles Police Department in California. And they had a rise and spike in drugs, alcohol use, gang violence, and he decided, along with his department, I'm going to do something about it. So in 1983, they started the DARE program. DARE stands for Drug Abuse Resistance Education, and they went into the public school system, and they started teaching the students about drugs and alcohol. And this is carried on over to today. Today, DARE is taught in all 50 states and multiple countries around the world. We have a conference every summer that I usually go to, and I meet people from Mexico, I meet people from Europe, and these are people that teach DARE just like I do in their countries. So it's a great program. I think it's needed. I think if you look around in society today, you'll see that there's a huge, huge drug problem. And don't think it's not here in Brewton, Alabama, because we see it on a regular basis, okay? So in moving with that, the DARE training that I received in 2012, and I told you this is my 10th going on 11th year this fall, was to be an advocate for you students. And that's what I intend to do. I intend to speak for you when you can't speak for yourself. I intend to back you up when you need backing up. So anytime you have an issue, that's my thing. I want to develop a relationship with each and every one of you. So when you see me out in public, when you see one of these gentlemen out in public, you wouldn't be scared to come talk to us. How many of y'all have seen me at Walmart before and not in uniform? A lot of you. A couple of you call you by name. You saw me there in shorts and flip-flops and a t-shirt, right? Still Officer Madison, but I'm just being average Officer Madison. And y'all come up to me and say hello, right? No. Some of you do. But that's the thing. I don't want you to be scared of us. The police are not here to make you scared. The police are here to help you, okay? Especially if you've got an issue with drugs and alcohol, not specific to you. But like I said, remember how we said resistance strategies, things that work to help you say no to drugs and alcohol? If you see something happening on the street, say something. Tell Miss Kay, tell Miss Oliver, tell me, tell Chief Nicholson if you see him. Tell somebody so we can help you, okay? Do y'all agree? Y'all can tell me, you'll say something if you see something? Yep, you can do better than that. If you see something, say something, okay? During the year, we try to make two criteria. One is these students, they take a DARE test in December. This year, we didn't get to do it until January because of some COVID issues. I was out covering some shifts. So we take a test to see what they learned. And also, in April, we have the students write an essay, a one-page essay. Now, I don't know how many of your students came home and said, I can't write one page. I told them in February, this is due in April. I can't write a page in 2 months. I don't know. I mean, I probably would have said the same thing when I was in fifth grade. But they were able to accomplish it. And now listen, I've got 4 students up here, but in no means do these 4 students outweigh any of you guys. I just had somebody that's separate from the police department go through these, and they picked out 4, and they said, here, let these 4 read their reports, okay? I know they're probably nervous. Are you guys nervous? Are you ladies, gentlemen, are you nervous? Okay. Does anybody want to go first? Anybody want to volunteer to go first? Aaron. Okay. Hey, real quick. Okay, by show of hands, who thinks Aaron should go first? Okay, hands down. Who thinks any of the ladies should go first? Okay, Aaron is. Okay, so listen. Y'all please give them your attention when I call them up here. They may be nervous, I don't know. Are you nervous? Okay. All right, so I'm going to give them a few minutes, let them have
take drugs, you can overdose, which is when you die from taking too many drugs. On average, 106,000 people die from overdose in 2021. The main cause of overdose is when people take too much fentanyl. On average, fentanyl is 50 times stronger than average used drugs. It is important to know about overdose and how it can affect you. Always make the best choices. My second reason you should not do drugs is you can have mouth cancer. It can be life-threatening if not treated early. Gum disease kills lie to